Passamos a palavra ao senhor André Labu, vice-diretor de Assuntos Financeiros e Corporativos da OCDE e presidente da Rede Internacional de Educação Financeira da OCDE-INFI.
I'm extremely happy to be here today. As mentioned previously, the center is live for some time now, and especially from July. But this is really the first official launch with regional and international experts, so that's very important. The OECD is very proud by the creation of the center between CVM and us. In fact, the center has a special status at the OECD. So we're obliged to have the approval of the supreme body of the OECD, the Council. So we feel that's a very important thing. And I can confirm the center truly exists. I can testify it actually physically exists. I was there. I saw the center. I saw the floor at CVM. I took picture. And I will bring back the picture to Paris to demonstrate, to show the existence of the center, which is a full floor at CVM, which is a very nice, by the way, exhibition on the special museum on the piece, which was very good. the center built on existing cooperation with Brazil and also a special program that we have with the region, the Latin American and Caribbean countries, and Andreas, our director on global relations at the OECD, will refer and expand on this, and you will have further information on this. I would wish to commend Leonardo, even if he's not here, for making it happening and for his vision, but especially to commend Vasco for his leadership, for the hard, fantastic work that he did develop for this and for creating the center. Vasco, that's wow. As Leonardo said, I wish also to highlight the fact that while supported generously by CVM and based in Brazil, the center will have a truly regional objective. That's important to keep that in mind, and a very operational one, which is, will be related to the knowledge sharing, dissemination of the INFE tools and the facilitation of data collection and research, which are essential to understand and also to develop a proper policy for financial education. If you don't know the need, you cannot really be efficient as policy makers. And this is matching fully the objective of the international network of financial education. As I mentioned yesterday already, this is a huge network, this is a huge machine, which comprises 260 institutions from 115 countries. We have very important data collection, research, which are conducted through a lot of working groups and which produce policy recommendation, policy guidelines. So we created recently also a technical committee. We have a research committee head by Anna Maria Lusardi, who will speak shortly after us. And all this work here in the center and all this work in Brazil, all this work in the region will benefit from the input from the network, the INFE network, and vice versa. Because that's important also to realize and highlight the fact that all this country and regional work will as well feed the work of the global network. And talking about that, I mean, we have to recognize that this region is increasingly active and proactive in the field of financial education. Just an example, the national strategies for financial education develop design in the several countries in the region. And in fact, 40% of all the countries at the global level which are designing, and this is the word designing national strategies at this stage, are from Latin America. But we will discuss all this later on today. We have a special session, and the focus is, of course, on the region, so you will have further information this morning and this afternoon. As I said yesterday, there is clearly a momentum for financial education. This is, of course, related to the crisis, but not only the crisis. This is also related to structural development. And our secretary was referring to the aging issues, which is a huge structural development that we have to take care. And so we have still a lot of work to do to promote financial education, financial literacy. I wish to insist, as I said yesterday, that financial literacy for us, but not only for us, for G20, for PISA, is really a comprehensive approach, which includes not only the knowledge, but also the skills, the behavior, the attitude. That's important, very important, to take that into consideration, and there are a lot of interrelation between all these issues. And this is, financial literacy is an issue which is growingly recognized at the worldwide level. Just to give an example, the next G20 presidency is a German presidency, and financial literacy is one of their priorities. I wish also to, coming on what Mansueto said, insist on the fact that financial literacy is, of course, essential to help people to face financial challenges, but also to understand the relevance of policy reform. So that's a unique, a very important instrument in this respect. Now, coming back also on the regional component of the center and the fact that regional activities are so important to make the work, and especially the global work, operational, I am extremely happy to announce you officially that together with CVM, we had a meeting on Tuesday, and that several institutions from the region reached a broad consensus on creating a new LAC, Latin America Caribbean regional network on financial education, working under the aegis of the International Network for Financial Education and the center. I think this is a very good development. This will allow to share experience between relevant authorities from the region, to benefit from the huge INFE work and also the center infrastructure and facilities. Most potential member of this network are already member of the network, and those who are not can easily join the network, for instance, through the status that we have, which is called regular member, and which is cost-free. So the regional network will work on the basis of its parent network and use the same model. It will be open to all relevant authorities, all sectoral authorities, securities, insurance, pension, the central bank, the Ministry of Finance, but also Ministry of Education. And that's very important here, and I would wish to insist on this, that extremely important to strengthen the relationship with the education world. The OECD has promoted for years the development of financial education at school and to start as early as possible. And I wish here to recognize the extremely important role, the key role of the teacher, which are fundamental in development, this financial education, and to recognize the attendance of not only the teacher, but a lot of students. You are most welcome, and we are so happy that you are here today with us. An example of this membership is Brazil. Brazil has two full members, CVM, the Central Bank, but also six, no less than six regular members of the INFE, including the Ministry of Education. So this network will also allow a strong cooperation with other stakeholders, including the private sector. That's important to underline this. We have a win-win approach with the private sector, of course, at certain condition. That's important to highlight that. And as well, very close cooperation with existing regional bodies, international bodies, CAF, SEMLA, or World Bank, for instance. And so we can address a lot of issues, general specific issues, including sectoral issues. And we encourage as well the member of the network to host meetings beyond the annual meeting which will be organized in Rio under the leadership of the center. So with all this good news, I will stop here and give the floor to my colleague, Andreas. Thank you.